What is going on, snipers? Naeem Alobaby here. I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful day today. Let's go ahead and dive right into our daily cryptocurrency analytics for today. We're going to be looking at price predictions over the next couple of weeks for Ripple, Cardano, NEM, Stellar, and Tron. We're going to talk a little bit about why we're seeing some breakouts over the past couple of days. Obviously, Ripple, as you guys can see, just broke out of its previous resistance level of 8,414 Satoshis and its support, which was around 6,243 Satoshis. If you guys are on our Discord, this is a free and open resource available for each and every one of you guys. The link is in the description below. I highly implore you guys to get on our Discord. It's an open and free community for you guys, and there's a tab here called Trading 101, and you guys can actually understand what it means to hit a breakout, what a support level and a resistance level is. I'm not going to get into the definition right now. However, what I am going to talk about is the indicators that I am going to use for this video. So if you guys don't know how to use indicators, I'm going to teach you guys as we do this. I'm going to be using the RSI, which is the relative strength index, which is going to be down here in purple. We're going to be using a volume and moving average exponential, or EMA, exponential moving average in short. So pretty much what we're seeing here with Ripple, we are bouncing on top of the EMA. The EMA is this blue line right here, and what you want to look for is for the actual candlesticks to be bouncing on top of that. If it's overlapping or under, that could be a sign of either stable price movements or negative price movement. But if it's bouncing over on top, that's an indication that the prices are going up, and then this is also going to be pointing upwards, which is also a good indication that this is going up. RSI is very high, guys. It's been over 70 this whole time. If it's over 70, it indicates something is overbought. But as you guys can see, it's happened before. RSI went really high, then that was an indicator that prices were going to drop. If you were swing trading this, you could have used the RSI to make some money here. But at this point, when we're seeing these all-time highs, we're seeing a huge buyer's market. If you look at the volume here, the volume is just insane. You see that we had a little bit of some low volume here, and then bam, went right back up to these high volumes. Primarily because, in my opinion, Ripple is on the news. It's everywhere. And when we look at total market cap here, Ripple is at $2.15. Past the $2 mark, it's ranked number two. It has passed Ethereum at a total of $83 billion in market cap, guys. If you look at Ethereum, man, it hasn't been, it hasn't let go of its spot for a long time. So for Ripple to take that away is just astounding and amazing. And I think it's a huge feat for Ripple. So that's pretty much what I look at for Ripple. If we are going to continue going upwards, you can't determine the magnitude of prices. You only can determine the direction. So what I can tell you is prices are obviously going up. How far is it going to go up? Well, I think maybe we'll hit some big evens like $2.50, $3. But at the end of the day, if people continue to come into the market and the demand is there, people are buying Ripple, it's going to continue to go up, guys. So if I see price movements going downward, I will definitely update you guys. Obviously, we have our live stream tonight. I think we're going to cover a lot of these breakouts and talk about when's a good price point to buy in, or if you are going to be selling for profits, where's a good place to sell. So once again, this isn't financial advice. I'm giving you my perspective as a trader, guys. So if we look at ADA BTC, Cardano is pretty big. It's popular with everybody. If you guys see here, we do have some very good support levels that were built around 2,578 Satoshis. If you guys don't know what Satoshis are, once again, on our Discord, we'll have that definition up for you guys on the Trading 101 tab here. Just make sure you open this up and then also go to resources if you guys want to use the trading view chart that I'm using right now and all of the exchanges that we use here. But pretty much a Satoshi is a fractionalized version of Bitcoin. It's almost like the cents to Bitcoin is kind of how I like to describe it. So you can see here, there was a beautiful pattern that was formed here. Right here, you saw this round pattern, and then it started going up, bouncing on top of the EMA, bouncing on top of the EMA, and then shot right on top of the EMA, went under, and now it's bouncing just on the EMA. It doesn't seem to be completely over it yet. It's not necessarily bouncing on it, in my opinion. It's just going over it. RSI is pretty high, so just like Ripple, we saw this breakout, expecting this to go a lot higher. Obviously, you see the screen snail stick is continuing to form, and Cardano could see prices increasing right now. What I'm really noticing in the market in total is that BTC dominance is dropping. We're at 40.2%. It's getting to a critical point for Bitcoin to see whether or not Bitcoin is going to hold its spot. I think this is where altcoins are going to start taking over, guys. 2018, I think in January, and this is, you know, just my opinion, I think in January, we're going to start seeing a little bit of a shift in the market towards focusing more on a value investor's type of investment rather than trying to just day trade and swing trade, which we'll still have a ton of that. Don't get me wrong. However, I think we're going to see a lot more investors come in. As we see institutional investors come in that have large sums of money, I think they're going to start looking for technologies like Ripple that have already established use cases with banks and so forth, or Ethereum that has its own smart contract system that's being built on top of. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens over the next couple of days, especially heading into 2018. As far as what we're seeing now, it looks like our previous resistance here at 3,189 Satoshis has now become the support level for this pattern, which is going to be really good for Cardano, knowing that we have some support here around 3,100 Satoshis. So once again, you can never determine the price magnitude of how high something's going to go or where the price point's going to end. You can always make predictions, but it's easier to predict where the price movements are headed. Obviously, bouncing on top of the EMA, volume is high. It's just a buyer's market, kind of how it is with Ripple right now. So going to be interesting to see where this heads up. If it does start heading down, I think it can find support around this 3,000 Satoshi level, and I think that'd be really good for this coin. Just a quick side note, guys, by the way, on our Discord, I am going to be giving you guys the opportunity to post on the channel. Once again, you guys know SniperStube is a community channel. If you guys know any great content creators that don't have as much of an audience or wants more exposure, if you want more exposure, we definitely are going to be taking submissions. We're going to vet every single submission and make sure it's high quality and actually adding value. If it's not, then we're not going to post it. It's only going to be added value content so that we can ensure that our viewers are getting the most out of our education. So I actually went down here. If you guys go to video suggestions, I listed a ton of videos that I've had on my mind. I just haven't had the ability to create because there's so much that people ask that there's not enough time to create the videos. So that's why, my vision for SniperStube has always been a community channel. So I can't wait to see which content creators are starting to submit their content. And then now you guys can have the ability to gain exposure on our channel. I'm really excited for that. I put a ton of different ideas here. You guys can do any video on cryptocurrency as long as it adds value, it's accurate, and the information is right. We're going to vet all our videos. And what's interesting is we can do anything. If it's mining, if it's about security, how to secure your wallets, how to have a secure Google two-factor authentication, just tons of different ideas you guys can do. So we can't wait for that. Just go on our Discord, link is in the description, go to the opportunity tab and read all of the rules and the requirements and the criteria that you must meet in order to have your video even posted on the channel, because we have to meet these high standards to bring the best quality to you guys. So hopefully you guys are excited about that. I'm very excited about that because I think we're going to have a lot more educational content on this channel for you guys to understand and really get into a little bit more of the basics so that you can actually understand the advanced courses and the training that we talk about, because you have to know the fundamentals. My mentor always taught me, he said, Naeem, always go back to the fundamentals. What do boxers always do when they want to get a little bit better? They have to go back to the fundamentals, get better at the fundamentals. That's always what helps an individual or a professional understand their craft and excel their craft. And then all the nuances you learn as you progress comes after the fundamentals are in place. So Cardano's, sorry for the quick personal development there, but Cardano's market cap here is at 13 billion. We're ranked number 5 at 53 cents. Could possibly start heading towards $1. Not so much of a diluted graph, which I like. Could be undervalued. As you guys know, if you are a Patreon, you guys know my portfolio. I just posted it on the Patreon website. The link is in the description below if you want to become a Patreon. And pretty much what I'm looking at right now with Cardano is something that I'm going to hold pretty much in the early part of 2018 to really see how prices mature. So volume is great, 266 million in volume right now. And it's just an exciting time, guys, for altcoins. Let's look at XEM, NEM. This is going to be an interesting one because it's seen a gradual price movement upwards. As you guys can see, over time, we have seen obviously this pattern form positive here, and it's really following this upward trend here, which is really cool because we can determine where to really put in our positions in terms of buy points. And what's cool here as well is what we're forming. You see it did round out, but we're jumping off of the EMA right now. This is a really good sign that we're seeing this upward price momentum. And then right here is where resistance was built earlier at 7,978 Satoshis with NEM. So what's be interesting to find is we can complete this pattern, go right back up to previous all-time highs. If that was all-time highs, it looks like it was. It may have been a little bit higher before, but yeah, it actually came from, if we look at the one-day chart, let's go ahead and pull this up here. So if you guys want to look at the past prices, you want to look at the one-day chart, and as you can see, we haven't even hit all-time highs. This is a graph that I really like because you see there's a downtrend, and then it obviously has an uptrend now, but what's cool about a graph like this is you can tell that prices have been at levels higher than where they're at now. So even at this point, we're hitting highs that we haven't hit in a while since August 3rd. And what's cool about that is we're going back to these levels, which could indicate price levels moving upwards over time. So I'm really seeing a lot of these altcoins starting to gain their value back, getting what they deserve. And I think that's really cool, guys. Once again, no way to determine price magnitude here, obviously, since there's a breakout. So what I would say in a graph like this, what you can do is watch these resistance levels, see how this acts apportionate to these resistance levels. Is it gonna test them or is it gonna blow right past them? Even at this point though, being that we have these clear support levels, if it does start heading down, RSI is pretty high. If it's over 70, guys, RSI is over 70, that stands for the relative strength index, it indicates something is overbought. And it's not always a 100% indicator. I mean, there's no guarantees in trading in general. However, it is a good indication that you may be able to get a better buy position at a lower price. So I am going to wait to see if this can mature a little bit. But if it does start heading towards this resistance and breaks out, I'm definitely going to put in a buy order to ensure that I can capitalize on those gains that we'll see with the breakout, because that's definitely a good day trade or even maybe a swing trade over time. So I'll definitely continue to watch this. We'll keep track of this in our live stream tonight. As you guys know, we do our live stream every single night. If you guys want to tune in tonight, we're at $1.04. We've crossed the dollar mark for NEM at $9 billion of market cap at rank number 8. Interesting to see that graph also not as diluted. USD value is through the roof, but BTC value isn't. And once again, you want to look at the Satoshi value, because you want to make sure that against Satoshis, against Bitcoin, you are also making profits, not just against the US fiat dollar. So let's look at XLM really quick, guys. So Stellar, check this out. We obviously have some good support levels that were built around 1,336 Satoshis. We broke out of that previous channel where we saw resistance around 1,700 Satoshis. That channel resistance level eventually became support level, which is always a good sign if you are gonna be investing long-term. Obviously, now you've got this price breakout. You can't determine the magnitude. Pattern is not there as well. So pretty much what we're looking at here is a graph that's going to either continue to build up its pattern upwards, or it's going to start creating a channel. In my opinion, what I would do with XLM at this point, for me personally, let's go ahead and pull up the one-day chart really quick just to take a little bit of a bird's eye view. Very similar to what we were seeing with the other chart. Now, what's interesting about this, guys, if you guys know about patterns, you guys understand that there are different patterns like cup and handles and so forth. And this is a clear cup and handle right here. So it's not something that you only can do with a 1 hour chart. This is something you can actually use over long trends, over long periods of time. So if you guys go on our Discord, once again, this is a free resource for you guys. You guys can go and look at how a cup and handle forms. You see this initial price movement upwards, you see the cup form, the cup base, and then you see a breakout point. When you look at this chart, that's exactly what you see here. You see the prices here. It comes out, you form a cup handle right here. This is the top. And then you see the cup base form. There's obviously some depth here. Once this depth has been created, you can look for the breakout. There you go. This is something that could have also been predicted, guys. You know, I can't just keep my eyes on charts 24/7. So, you know, that's why I implore you guys to educate yourself. Get on these platforms, because if you're not, guess what? You will be outspoken and people will beat you, guys. You have to be proactive. I like this new mic I just got, by the way. Thank you to all of the Patreons. You guys help out with all of the new equipment. We're going to have a lot of new equipment coming soon. So anyways, guys, I don't want to get too deep here, but that's the fact of the matter. Patterns can indicate price movements, guys, and that can make you a lot of money. So let's go ahead and look at Stellar. What are we looking at total market cap? $5 billion, rank number 11, heading towards number 10. If you guys know about Stellar, just a quick background story, this was actually a fork of Ripple. That's probably why you're seeing a 40% upward trend right now. And the founder of Ripple actually created Stellar, and he had a little bit of a different vision. The story is completely different. It's out of this world, but you guys have heard me talk about it in the actual live stream. But you know, he created Ripple, he created Mt. Gox. He's created a lot of great things, some of them not working out so well, like Mt. Gox, but some of them like Ripple that have worked out extremely well. Now what we're seeing with Stellar is obviously some price movements going up, probably because there is a link to Ripple. And at the end of the day, I had some Stellar in my portfolio. If you guys are patrons, you know that. So we're reaping off of all of these gains. And I hope you guys are too, because at the end of the day, that's what this channel is for, to implore and give you guys perspective for you guys to make your own educated decisions. So finally, let's finish up with Tron, guys. Tron has been in the news. A lot of you guys are talking about Tron. You saw that pump. Let's look at resistance, supports. So this is our support level here, right around 217 Satoshis. This is going to be a smaller token, but what I do want you guys to keep note of is this downward trend. So obviously this is going down. The triangle is forming a descending pattern here. I would not even have a position on this right now, just being the fact that support levels are right around 220. Maybe if we do start finding more support around this level, could be a potential buy long term. Do I see any huge swings? Maybe. We have seen a couple of them, so we'll definitely see what happens. Maybe this will go back down to support and do the exact same thing it did here and then form another upward channel, which would be a good swing trade. So I'd continue to watch on Tron, let the chart mature. As you guys can see, we're at rank number 19, just headed into the top 20 at $2.5 billion market cap. So it's going to be an interesting coin to watch. Prices are not that diluted as well. So we'll see as volume increases. It's already at 254 million, which is astounding for a coin like that. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys are enjoying the channel and the Discord and the community. Once again, if you guys want to have your content out there, if you guys want to be able to post on this channel, maybe you want some exposure for your personal channel, maybe you just want to contribute value to the community, I'm opening the door for you guys. This is your opportunity to take advantage of the network that we've built here and go ahead and post content on the channel. So go in the Discord under opportunity. I can't wait to see some of your submissions and see more of you guys adding value to the community. And with that being said, guys, like always, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and snipers out.